Hey everyone, it's coming to you from the cusp, 8:30 in the morning, 9th of May, 2016, of course, day after Mother's Day. A little bit of an overcast day, kind of cool actually. Got up this morning, it was, chill on. Not that bad, but the weather's been just a mixed bag. You know, we've been looking at, we're already a month ahead of schedule with planting, I'm already planting. And this is all from gardeners and local farmers who've been living here. This is other people telling me, because I'm still, I'm not a gardener. I've had, hobby gardens my whole life. Big gardeners, big farmers, hobby farms. But more than that, the whole, in my opinion, the world is a complete mess. It's completely just backwards. In the I don't turn the news on. All I need to do is listen to the meme that's going around and whatever's talking, at the water cooler. If you really just stand back and really pretend that you don't know anything and just look at what's going on and see and feel how messed up things are. I mean, I've been off the news and the television for so long that it's almost like I can't even talk to some people that then they're going on about what's real and they're speaking as if it's gospel. And it's true. Osama bin Laden brought those towers down. Lee Harvey Oswald shot JFK. There's no... and even I noticed this couple of things. I was just, because I'm a Star Trek geek. And I'll notice the way they use words, and then they'll change, and they'll manipulate words in the show itself, and then they'll manipulate words in the news broadcasts. Even though I'm not watching news, I do get some from my internet feed, but... an episode of called Casino Royale, and in the show there was a murder. A guy comes in and literally shoots the bellboy, pow. And then the character, the bald-headed Captain Picard dude, he says, "Yes, the shootout between the bellboy and the bar." And I'm like, shootout? When did a murder become a shootout? A shootout is like when two people are shooting back at each other. They had a shootout. The gunfight at the OK Corral, I believe people were shooting back at five. And don't quote me on that, that's way back. But if you'll notice it, they'll say one thing in the beginning of whatever narrative that they'll be doing. And I'm only quoting television because that's all I can quote. So with the insanity that's going on the planet and with them changing words and changing meanings of things, I'm not surprised. People don't know what's going on, I don't know. So, that's one thing I do know is that I don't know. That's about the best thing I can say. One thing I do know is I don't know. I like that, so. So, pretty mellow day here in the yard. I just got my garden going. I'll give you a little tour. Coffee there. That's my garden. I will be doing the strawberries in the back, of course. That's catnip. Has to be protected at night, or else all the other neighborhood cats just totally go crazy. Those three beds are being taken out. That's where my little breakfast patio is going to be, where I can have breakfast because the sun just beats down here in the morning if there is sun. So my strawberries. This will be tomatoes and potatoes. But not a big garden this year. I just don't feel like it. Just tomatoes, potatoes is what I like. And we gotta fix that hole, put grass there. That's where whoever had the house before, it was an RV parker, so. This is my neighborhood. There's my beautiful Kuskanax Mountain, where my Vicky's View, my favorite hike. Really simple yard. I got one yard. My house is all the way on one tucked in corner. And right around the corner, you can't see it right now, but there's the mountain range, and that's Saddle Mountain, just down the road there, and if you turn to the left, you'll be able to see Saddle Mountain. So, my abode, I only have one neighbor, which is pretty cool. He's a good guy too, him and his wife are really nice. If you're ever in the cusp, a good cup of coffee, I'm in the book. It's not a very big town. And peace to you. In this crazy world that we've got going. Don't lose your... And that's another thing I wanted to mention. Don't lose your cheese, man. A lot of people are losing their stuff. I noticed that completely.
Just absolutely losing their stuff, like coming unhinged for nothing. You know, if your cheese slips off the cracker, you're not going to be any good to anybody, your family, your kids. You got to keep your stuff together. I know, and it's almost impossible to say that, like, to do that right now in this crazy situation we got going on, you know. But don't lose your cheese over little things. Like, for me, you know, I got a horrendous kind of revenue tax bill. They've audited me all the way back to 2009, and it's a pretty substantial amount, but, you know, I'm not going to let it get me down. They want to keep you down. They'll do anything they can to keep you down, whether it be financial, physical, mental, whatever. But do the best you can to keep your cheese on your cracker. Keep your stuff packed. Take care. Peace to you.